us not the right methodology or the right approach in order to educate and infuse our system with the right teachings that Allah SWT wants us to abide by, and the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam wants us to adhere towards. In order, therefore, to save God ourselves from being victims to fabrications and other ways of negligent information and exaggeration of how we feel about a particular idea, such as, for example, to deny the very existence of God Himself, or the acceptance of certain practices, and we assume they constitute part and parcel of our faith, we must establish a scale of thinking for ourselves on the basis of the truth by which we can judge our behavior and conduct, hence guiding our souls and mind to proper and sound thinking that will act as a barrier between us and such temptations, in order that this may equip us with spiritual powers to defend anxiety, fantasy, and wild unrealistic imagination, and maintain and aid our faith from any innovation or additions. And this is not easy. I mean, what I just said is not easy to digest, because we've been proven to believe something else. We have been proven to believe that whatever you see in front of you is how you take it and how you accept it. And you're not even allowed to challenge it or even ask questions about it. Because if you do, then you are actually doubting the very fiber and the very education system that had put us in it. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have said this and I will repeat this a million times. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came into a community, he challenged the very fiber and paradigm of that community and society that he was in. Why he did that? In order to make them think. Something that we don't allow our communities these days to do. Something we don't even allow our children to do. It's either my way or God's road. No! It's either my way or Faisal road. And it's either my way or the highway. Things don't work in that way. It is either my way, and let me share your expertise on the matter. It is my way, and lend me your intellect in the matter. Just like Imam Ali sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he says, "An shawara nas, faqad shawara fi udurihim." Imam Ali says, the one who consults people, he adds part of their intelligence to his intelligence. You're not losing as you are actually in the process of consulting with others. If anything, you are adding insult to your information. Imam Ali, in another incident, says, half of knowledge, to gain knowledge, in order to get halfway to knowledge, is to ask. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a human over a human. And when a human is put in charge of other humans, he's only put in charge of other humans in order to regulate and advance their life, not to abuse their life and take advantage of their disadvantage situation that they already face and they are already in. If we allow them to have them, then we are endorsing tyranny, oppression, subjugation to be part and parcel of our system. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has indicated that with the most emphatic words in the Quran when he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُوا change it from it. You know, just keep the same concept we have, as we often repeat it. When the month of Ramadan comes, we put our responsibilities of negligence on whom? On Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet Allah provides us the opportunity to change our communities and societies. For example, someone comes and says, why there is so much poverty in the world? Allah is unjust. Wait. The question is not about God being unjust. The question is there enough wealth in the world or not? That's what we need to determine. If there is, then the problem is not with insufficient funds. The problem is with lack of distribution of funds. And when we find that there is lack of distribution of funds, then don't shift the blame to Allah. Shift the blame to fellow human beings who are so stingy and holding to their money that they are not willing to part away with it towards the underprivileged. When we speak about those who are underclothed and they don't yet have enough, before you shift the blame to Allah, go and open your closet and see how many saris do you have, how many sherwanis, how many kanzus, how many suits, how many pants, how many shirts, and then multiply by 5 billion of the people around you. And you know what? Let's say there is 1 billion unclothed people. There is another 4 billion clothed people with closets full of clothes. And who is unjust? Allah or a human being towards one another? There is no injustice in the world in as much as a human exercise injustice against one another. And Allah Ta'ala said to himself, I have made injustice not prohibited for me. And Allah says, I could never, ever, under any circumstances, allow injustice to take place in as far as my dealings concerned with my servants. Since I have made injustice prohibited for me, let what Allah then says, and Allah says, since I made injustice to the plane. Hang on to it. It's your safety and passage towards salvating yourself and salvaging yourself. And if they decide not to go for the path of intelligence, when Allah SWT says, Inna Hadaynahu Najdayn, we have guided man and equipped him with the two paths, or the two faculties. What are we talking about? Is it in the bank? No, we're talking about the mind and the hands.
Sincerity and knowledge from committing felonies and mishaps and sins.
pressing Allah's law and start deciding for people whether Allah is going to accept his rules or not accept his rules. When someone prays and doesn't fast, you think Allah is going to accept your prayers? Allah is not going to accept your prayers. But Allah, let me tell you what Allah is. One day, two people in the family of the Israelites, they were arguing with one another. One was saying that I am a sinner, and I think Allah will forgive me if I am sincere, and I ask him for his forgiveness. Another guy prays, gives charity, perhaps hearing, whatever. He said, by Allah, Allah has made that forgive me. You know what Allah says? Allah, when you want to have to give me, maybe I need Allah, you know what that means? Who's using my name in vain? Who gives him the authority? Who gives him the authority to use my name in vain and say and make an oath on my behalf that I will not forgive him? Who gives you that right? Allah inspires to them that because of your statement, I have forgiven all your sins. Allah, object to me. Now, object to Allah. Just like when people put to be more sustaining than sustaining himself. Your family is not family himself. And some people have thought you want to be more Allah than Allah himself. Well, yeah, we don't have that position. We don't have authority to say we are assuming Allah's position among the creations. Allah says, Al-Khalqu bi-yani, wa al-Habbu ila bi-yani, al-Fahmu ila bi-yani. Allah Akbar. A statement. Allah says what? Creations are my children. Not authority. Not authority. And best among my creation are the ones who are best to my children. And best among my creations are the ones who are best to my children. Not authority. And Allah then says what? I insan sinam Allah. She says, what? Man is God creation. God is the one that brings his human in life. God, the one that brings that human being to rule. On the basis of what? Humiliation, subjugation, control, oppression, injustice, whatever the case may be. If you want to bring my creation to rule, the one that doesn't is God in the eyes of the one subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the Prophet says, when he says, the most perfect Muslim and the matter of faith is the one who has excellent behavior. And the best among you are those who behave best towards their wives. Subhanallah. The best among you are the ones who are best to their wives. And you know the Prophet concludes by saying, of creation towards his family. Because the Prophet never abused his family, never the Prophet was heard to say something that may undermine the status of the young or the old, in his family or outside his family. What else? It is very sad that this relationship which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has established for the good has been made a source of contention, deception, treachery, tyranny, and humiliation. And again, brothers and sisters, I'm talking about the question of marital relationship between husband and wife. Follow the principle of consultation with one another and make decisions as families. There will be much more harmony in the family when decisions are not imposed on everyone. Because everyone then will feel, if you consult them, that they had some skill to do with that decision making. Let your partner feel she is considered by you as a real human being and not just an extra number in the household.
Everyone thought I'm talking about someone else. No, you're right.
most important